We're going to do an energy balance on a human where we're given data on how much heat would be generated from metabolic activity in 8 hours. And so we're going to look at two models. One, if the person's body is modeled as a closed system, assume water is a reasonable heat capacity for that, and what temperature to get to. The other is, let's model it as an open system, constant temperature, how much water would evaporate. Let's do the first part, apply the energy balance. The first law is delta H is equal to Q. We can use delta H because for liquid, water, delta H and delta U are almost the same. And Q, of course, is known. Delta H is going to be the number of moles of water times the heat capacity of water times the temperature change, and this can be equal to Q, which is 5 megajoules. Now, what we're going to do, number moles of water, we have 58 kilograms, and there's 18 grams per mole, and there's 10 to the third grams per kilogram. The heat capacity for water in joules is 75.3 joules per mole Kelvin. And now delta T is what we're going to solve for. 5 megajoules corresponds to 5 times 10 to the 6th joules. So I can solve this for the temperature change, and I get a temperature change of 20.6 degrees C, which would imply the final temperature start at 37, end up at 57.6 degrees C. Not a very realistic model. Person would be dead at about 44 degrees C. So closed system is not a good model. So now let's look at an open system model to see if that might be a better approximation by calculating the amount of water that would evaporate in order to maintain the temperature constant. So again, first law, delta H equals Q. Now delta H is going to be the mass of water that evaporates times the heat of vaporization, which I'm going to look up in the steam tables. And it's going to be equal to the same Q, 5 times 10 to the 6 joules. So let me look up the heat of vaporization. So I put in the heat of vaporization at 37 degrees C. I then convert it to joules so that we have joules on both sides. So now I can solve for the mass of water that would evaporate to keep the temperature constant, 2.1 kilograms. So this is about 2 liters of water evaporating would keep the temperature constant. Well, this is probably high for someone that's sitting still. You can find online values like 0.4 liters per day from sweating, maybe 0.4 liters today from moisture left by breathing. But someone is exercising 1 to 1.5 liters per hour, with numbers going up as high as 4. So this is at least not a totally unreasonable number and a much better approximation for maintaining the constant temperature.